Good morning. We are back for another Vlogmas. Ignore my hair. Please, it's still wet. We're back. We're back. It is now on to day eight, my favorite number. Do you have a favorite number? Mine is eight. Let's figure out what we've got. Alien Goddess. Alien Goddess by Mugler. The packaging is quite nice. So Mugler is the brand or fragrance house, but Alien Goddess is the fragrance that we're gonna try. Standard sampler bottle. I'm not going to, don't read this. Let your nose tell you. Here we go. Ooh. Ooh. Oh. Is there rose in this, but not too much rose? Like, I'm smelling floral. Let me say that. Flowers. I'm smelling floral. So I would think, let's spray the other side. Something that's a bit on the sweet side, but I'm still getting a little maybe peony, rose, peony, but then there's something sweet. So, what is that? It's nice. It's nice. Maybe vanilla is in there. Could be vanilla. Flowers and vanilla. I'm not mad at this though. Kind of like it actually. Let me make sure it's not a toilette. No, it's an eau de parfum.
It is a rainy day in the A, but we are here and we are finally going to talk about the Mugler Alien Goddess scent. Okay, I was talking to Lisa all the way here, so we've been on the phone. Let's go ahead and go to Fragrantica. Mugler. Where is Mugler from? Okay, it doesn't matter. I'll check on that later. I do want to say this while I'm pulling this stuff up. When I do these first impressions of these fragrances, I genuinely don't review the fragrance house if I've never heard of it. I don't review the collection the fragrance is coming out of. I am going off of my genuine, authentic, organic reaction to my first scent from this brand or fragrance house. So that's why the Guerlain didn't know they had this type of collection, didn't know it was actually in a summer kind of collection because I didn't look it up until after. So I wanted to let you know that these are all first impressions, which I'm not trying to toot my own horn, but toot toot. I'm doing pretty well. Anyway, so we talked earlier that it smells very floral, maybe vanilla. I'm smelling more vanilla now, honestly. Yeah, I'm smelling more vanilla now. So here are the main accords. Vanilla, powdery, white floral, woody, citrus, musky. Okay. Really? I was thinking like a rose, so maybe what is hell? Okay. Anyway, let's go through the perfume pyramid. So top notes, coconut water and bergamot. I never liked coconut. I'm probably the only Jamaican that doesn't like coconut. Anyway, but I love bergamot. You guys know I love bergamot. In the middle, we have jasmine and heliotrope. Is it the heliotrope? I don't even know how heliotrope smell. I'm gonna look that up after the base notes. Bourbon, vanilla, and cashmere. Okay. let's go ahead and find out a little bit more about the heliotrope. This flower, almond smelling, vanilla like. Okay, so maybe it's a mixture of that with the jasmine that maybe is throwing me for a loop a little bit. Okay, I think this is definitely going on the clothes. It also says on the card, floral oriental, and I do like that. I do like that. Vibrant bergamot essence and spellbinding infusions of jasmine and bourbon vanilla. Floral oriental woody. Again, I think sampler sets are a beautiful thing. You get to play around with a lot of different fragrances. You probably wouldn't have mustered up that courage to buy it on your own because you just don't know if you're gonna like it for more than a day or two. But this way, you can get at least two or three outings out of it. And I say outings because, I mean, you might spray it on and stay in the house, spray it on, go to the store, spray it on, and go out with your friends. And then you realize, like, okay, I think this is one that I need to purchase. I have a blind buy that I have been waiting to open. And I wanted to wait until after all of these were done. And I think I'm going to do another blind buy this weekend. Blind buys are pretty nerve-wracking because you just don't want to get it wrong, because you'll end up with a bottle of something and you're like, I don't even like this like I thought I did. Or you are dependent on someone that you've seen on social media and be like, oh, well, if they like it, I'll like it. Not necessarily. Remember that fragrances deal with your body chemistry just like they do with the different notes in it. Your body might not like Baccarat Rouge. Your body might not like Tom Ford Velvet Orchid. I'm going to take my hair out right now before more people see me like this. And then I'm going to go inside, have my tea. Candy's daughter is texting me. I have friends with kids that can text. I'm old now. Let's go to work. Good evening. I am waiting on the video to post. And I'm also thinking about what my next set of videos will be, because we've officially done one full week. And I know that I've had some idea of what direction these Vlogmas videos would go in. I knew that I wanted to talk about fragrance because that's something that I think a lot of people can enjoy once they realize, like, hey, I like this, maybe I like that, but maybe I don't like that because of that one thing in it. But I do enjoy learning about fragrances and what I truly like smelling. But I also miss cooking different recipes, trying out new things. You know, I love a good beverage as well. So tomorrow, I'm gonna wait until Friday. We'll do the next one. But I also want to bring the cooking back. In my earlier vlogs this year and the beginning of the pandemic, I would try all of these different recipes, and I used to call it Saute with Sil on Instagram. That is what it's called. And I'm going to bring a few of those back. Not those recipes, but new recipes that I've wanted to try and see how that goes. And I feel like I've talked about this in like older videos, but I want to look the part. But once I get heavily invested in something and I'm focused on this one thing, I need to do that. And then I start looking like this. And then when I finally do put myself together, people are like, oh man, how are you? I can do it. I just don't. And then I don't have anywhere to really go. But you're supposed to always dress for your day. You know what I mean? And that goes back to my health
And even though I enjoy working out, it is the consistency piece of working out. Once I get upstairs and I'm showered and I'm in my bed, I'm just gonna take some time to reflect on what is it that I want? What do I want the rest of Vlogmas to look like? What do I want for my career goals? And kind of like a pregame, a precursor to all of those beginning of the year videos that we all see about setting your intentions, vision boards, planning, organizing your life, getting into the perfect morning routine, you know, those kind of motivational, inspiring videos that we all end up seeing closer to the tail end of the year and the beginning of the year. I'm just going to have some me time. Organize and sort my life out. At least for the next couple of weeks, because that's kind of what I'm wanting to do. I need to really stop playing around, and this designation that I want, I need to really hone in on that. I need to really have tunnel vision, because that would be more money for me. 9 exams, 9 classes, that's it, 9. And then I would be an even more well-respected underwriter with the designation behind my name. I need that. I want that. I want that money. So yeah, that's kind of where I am with that. I just wanted to share that with you because I know that this vlog today hasn't really been about anything, but just a little chat. So the blind buy, I'm still not sure if I want to do a Zara fragrance, not Ebony Woods. And I'm sorry, that was rude. I just don't want to pick up Ebony Woods just because everybody has been talking about Ebony Woods. And I feel like y'all are doing too much. You're doing a lot. So I'm gonna let it cool off. And if they never bring it back, so what? Because I can't miss something I've never had. So there's that. But there is another long list of fragrances that I do want to try. And we've talked about those before. Let's move on from the Zara talk. I do have a few. When I say a few, I mean like 12. Middle Eastern fragrances that I am interested in. I'm curious. I want to know more. So I maybe got one already. And I'm thinking about the other one, and maybe a day or two after the advent calendar that we're doing, the fragrance calendar, is over, and then we'll go into our blind buys. After that, we're gonna do some food things. We're gonna do some food things, definitely. But I will finalize all that stuff probably this weekend. And Lisa and I are gonna link up again. We've been having a lot of time to do that, and hopefully you guys will enjoy that as well. Yeah, I'm just giving you the updates, giving you the deets, you know what I mean? Am I going to the gym tomorrow? Am I going to Orange Theory in the morning? There is a 5 a.m. class available with my favorite coach. Quietly, I'm one of those people that checks the workout, even though you're not supposed to know what the workout is. At Orange Theory, you're supposed to find out when you get there, but we don't care about that. Some of us are gonna look, because I don't wanna do burpees. So anyway, let's see. Tomorrow's workout is it up? Ooh, it's an ESP day. I love a good ESP day. Okay, let me see. I'm gonna show it to you guys on the screen because I know people are like, oh, Orange Theory, what are you guys doing there? Well, this is gonna look crazy to you, but this is what we're doing. 150 meter all out row, okay. Squat jacks, repeat, 5 reps, okay. 10 neutral grip alternating shoulder press, gorilla row, kneeling plank bird dog, okay. And the TRX, oh yeah, I'm going tomorrow. Yeah, we like this. Yeah.
yeah, yeah, I got a ring. I got the money, it's come through the ring. Shawty, she pumping, she bumping the head. I got the money, I'm up from the ring. I had to wake up and count up the bread. I had to wake up